Good morning students. Today we are going to see from this topic your new point factor theorem. Okay, so from this word we can understand everything whatever is given into this factor theorem. Okay, so factor means what? If you will see the simple division, see here, supposed to be here one of the number, this is the divided, 16 divided by 4. 16 divided by 4, then you will get what? 4 4 are 16. Okay, so you will get remainder is 0. This is your divided, this is your quotient, and this is your what we can say, it is divisor. Okay, so when you will carry out such a type of division, if in any division if you are getting the remainder is 0, then we can say this divisor is the factor of your dividend. Okay, so the same thing we have to learn into this factor theorem. So as we know that this dividend means, let we will take supposed to be your, this is the polynomial p of x. Okay, so this is divisor means your q of x, or divisor g of x we can represent, means supposed to be this is your divisor. And when you will divide by this divisor to your dividend, means to this polynomial, if you are getting the remainder is 0, then we can say that this divisor is the factor of your this polynomial. Okay, understood everyone? So if in this factor theorem, let suppose to be the p of x is any of the polynomial with degree 1 or greater than or equals to 1, and any real number, right? So if means x minus a is the factor of your given polynomial p of x, when it is possible if p of a equals to 0. What is the x minus a is the factor of given polynomial p of x if, when it is possible, p of a is equals to 0. Okay, so x minus a is the factor means we have to find out first value of x, right? As we have learned into the remainder theorem. So x minus a equals to 0, there a is any real number will be there, right? So x minus a is equals to 0, then we are getting the x value. Okay, so x value will come negative also, or x value will come positive also. Okay, and we are putting this x value into the given polynomial, and after keeping the value of x into the given polynomial, if you are getting the p of a is the remainder, means 0 you are getting the remainder, then we can say that this divisor is the factor of your given polynomial. Understood? Now second thing is there, here p of a equals to 0. When it is possible p of a equals to 0? When x minus a is the factor of your given polynomial. Got it? Now we will see the different example based on your factor theorem. Okay, first example is here. Use factor theorem to determine whether x plus root 2 is a factor of this polynomial 2 root 2 x square plus 5x plus root 2. Okay, in this example here it is not mentioned this is the factor of this given polynomial. We have to check whether it is the factor of the given polynomial, yes or no, right? So what are the conditions we have learned? If it is the factor of the given polynomial, then remainder should 0. Okay, so we have to use the value of x. We have to prepare the value of x from this factor and put into this given polynomial. Okay, so here when you will solve, you have to write what is your p of x. It is the polynomial 2 root 2 x square plus 5x plus root 2. Okay, and what is your factor? It is given g of x, we have to, then x plus root 2. Okay, so this, from this x plus 2 we have to find the value of x. So you will get x plus root 2 equals to 0. So x equals to this plus root 2, we will shift to right side of your 0, then you will get minus root 2. This is the value of x that we have to use into this given polynomial instead of x. Okay, so p of what x you got? Minus root 2. Okay, so 2 root 2 into x square. X square will be 2 square. Minus root 2 square. Correct? So plus 5 into minus root 2. And this plus root 2 is there. Okay, now here we will simplify this. This 2 root 2 multiply by every negative number having square is positive, and if the number into the root sign, then every root number square is a number itself. So negative number square will come positive and root square number will come that number itself. So you will get 2, root 2 square is 2 only, correct? So and again plus, now this plus minus will come minus, the product of the positive and negative term will be negative, so we will write here minus, this 5 root 2 will be there. We cannot say this 5 to the 10, okay, because this is simply the number and this is root number, so you will get here 5 root 2 and this plus root 2, okay. Now here this we will make the multiplication of this whole number in there, and here is the whole number. So 2 2's are 4. Okay. So 4 root 2 minus 5 root 2 plus root 2. Okay. So you can carry out like this addition, subtraction, or simply see this 4 root 2, this positive term and this positive term. This 4 root 2 are there and this is only 1 root 2 are there. So you will get 5 root 2. Okay, if you will add this, then you will get 5 root 2. And this minus 5 root 2. Okay, this plus 5 root 2 and this minus 5 root 2, you will get 0. Okay, so after simplifying this, we got the P of A, means your this number that we have taken from your factor of which x value is root 2 minus root 2. So you got here P of minus root 2 equals to 0, that is your remainder got 0. It means that this factor x plus 2, x plus root 2 is a factor of your given polynomial. That only we have to check whether it is factor of given polynomial, yes or no. So what we will write? X plus root 2 is a factor of 2 root 2 x square plus 5x plus root 2. Understood everyone? Now we will see next example. Next example, find the factor of k if x minus 3 is a factor of k square x square minus kx minus 2. So in this example, it is given that if x minus 3 is a factor of this given polynomial. So if any number is the factor of the given polynomial, then what you will get? Yes, you will get the remainder is 0. Okay. So here, this your polynomial P of x equals to k square x square minus kx minus 2, and your g of x here, x minus 3. Now it is, if it is the factor of this given polynomial, then you will get 0, right? So if x minus 3 equals to 0, you will get here x value is positive 3, right? So when you will solve this fp of 3 must be 0, well, if the x minus 3 is a factor of polynomial. Okay, so here P of 3 equals to k square. What is the x value we have given here? 3 square minus k into 3 minus 2. Your direct bracket is there between these two letter and this number. It means that what is the relation between these? It is multiplication. Okay, so here P of 3 will be what? 0, when you will compare with this, so this 0 will be there. Then k square, 3 square is 9 minus 3k into 3, that is 3k minus 2. Okay. So here k square multiplied by 9, 9k square minus 3k minus 2 equals to 0. So you will write this again into the different form, means just only we will change the sign here. 9k square minus 3k minus 2 equals to 0. So in this example, what we have to find? We have to find the value of k. Is here you got the value of k? No, of course not. So here you got the given polynomial in which form? Equation form, which quadratic equation. Okay, so we have to find the value of k. For that purpose, we have to simplify this or we have to solve. Okay, so here 9k square minus 3k minus 2 equals to 0. To find the value of k, we will solve this polynomial by which method? Splitting middle term method. Okay, so here when the splitting middle term method, what we are finding? We are actually finding the values of x, y and so on. What you hear here, what you used? K. Okay, so when you will solve this splitting middle term by splitting middle term, so 9 multiplied by this last constant term is minus 2. We have to make the multiplication. So what is the multiplication? Minus 18, right? Now we have to split up this number in such a way that what is your middle term? Minus 3. So we have to find two factors of your 18 in such a way that the addition of these two numbers must be minus 3 and multiplication must be minus 18. Okay, so which are the two numbers? So we have to find the pairs of two numbers. Okay, so 3 6 are 18, that one of the pair is there, right? 2 9s are 18, but 2 and 9, that what is the difference between the 2 and 9? It is 7. Okay, another pair, 6 3s are 18, means two numbers are which one? 6 and 3. So what is the difference between the two number is 3. So of course we can try to use that this pair 3 6 are 18. Okay, so multiplication 3 6 are 18 is there, but we want negative number. Okay, difference between these two number is 3, but we want minus 3. So when you will get the addition or subtraction, addition of such a two numbers is negative, where the bigger number is negative. So we will keep here negative sign and here we will keep positive sign. So plus 3 minus 6, addition you are getting minus 3, and plus 3 multiplied by minus 6, you are getting here minus 18. So these rules we have learned into the integers, right? So we will use here this instead of this middle term, we will write this 3k and minus 6k. Okay, so 9k square plus 3k minus 6k. Instead of this term only we will write this terms. Okay, this is called the splitting middle term. So minus 2 equals to 0. Now before that, how much terms was there? 1, 2 and 3. Now we got 4 terms are here. So we will make the group of 2 to each, that we have already learned into the simple equations lesson. Okay, so which one is the common factor in these two terms? Of course k is there, because here 1k, here k are how many times? 2 times, so k will be there. Again 9 and 3, so these two are the multiples of the 3. So what is the common factor? 3 is there, right? Because 3 3s are 9 and 3 1s are 3, so we can take this 3. Okay, so in bracket, now from these two terms we have taken common 3k. Now we have to say this table up till 9. So 3 3s are 9 and k is how many times here? 1 times. Here we want 2 times, so 1k will be there. Understood? Now again this 3k is already out, so what is remaining here? 1. Okay, here 1. So 3 3s are 9, k square, then 3k 1s are 3k. If it is negative sign is there, of course you give the negative sign. okay, then is here is a k, is here k, no, so k will be not common factor. So again which one now remaining, 6 and 2, so which one number will be the common, 2, because 2 3s are 6 and 2 1s are 2, so 2 will come common outside, then we can write 2 3s are 6 and this k. When you will get this minus sign, so minus plus minus, okay, minus plus minus, so 2 1s are 2 equals to 0. Of course whatever will becomes, if it is right, then whatever comes in the first term, that only will becomes into the second bracket, okay. So here now we will take this 3k plus 1 and 3k minus 2 equals to 0, okay. So from this we will find out the values of k. So here k plus 1 we have to equate with 0 and 3k minus 2 is also we have to equate with 0. So 3k plus 1 equals to 0. So you will get 3k equals to minus 1. Okay, so k equals to minus 1 by 3. This one value we got of the k. And again here 3k minus 2 equals to 0. So 3k equals to 2, so k equals to 2 by 3. So these are the values of k. Understood everyone? Now the values of k are k equals to minus 1 by 3 or k equals to 2 by 3. Okay, now we will see next example. Next example, find the values of a and b so that the polynomial x cube minus ax square minus 13x plus b have x minus 1 and x plus 3 as a factor. Okay, so in this example we have to find the value of a and b, right? So it means for which values of a and b this x minus 1 also x plus 3 becomes a factor of this given polynomial, right? So when this becomes a factor, or when this x minus 1 and x plus 3 are the factors of this given polynomial, it means that after dividing this polynomial by x minus 1, you will get remainder 0, and after dividing by x plus 3 to this given polynomial, you will get 0. So like this, it becomes the 0, remainder becomes the 0. So for that purpose, what are the values of a and b that we have to find out, okay. So now we will take this your polynomial p of x equals to x cube minus ax square minus 13x plus b. So for that first we will use your g of x equals to x minus 1. So you will get here, now everyone knows how to find the values of x. Okay, so here you will get x equals to 1. Okay, so what remainder should be there for f of 1? Sorry, for p of 1 it should be 0. So remainder should be 0. Okay, so ax cube here p of 1 equals to x cube. X cube means whose cube? 1 cube minus a into x square, whose square? 1 square minus 13 into 1 plus b, that we have to equate with, this is 0. So 1 cube is 1, okay, minus a into 1 square, 1 square is 1, that is a here, minus 13 plus b. Okay, so here plus 1 minus 13, so you will get minus 12. So minus a plus b minus 12 equals to 13. So you will write here minus a plus b minus 12 equals to 0. This is your first equation. Okay. Now here we will take for this same polynomial with the factor x plus 3. Right. So here second factor you will write g of x equals to x plus 3, for that you will get x equals to minus 3. Then, so p of minus 3 should be 0 if when a and b are, you will get, and then for that value on a and b, these polynomials you will get the remainder 0, means they becomes the factor of this given polynomial. Okay, so here p of minus 3 equals to what will be the x cube? X cube means whose cube? Minus 3 cube minus a into minus 3 square minus 30 into minus 3 plus b. Right, it is? Okay. Then here, what with which value you have to equate this? Yes, we have to remainder take 0. Okay. So here, now minus 3 cube is 27, positive or negative? Of course, negative. Okay. Then here, this minus and every negative number square is positive. So you will get how much? 3 square is 9. So 9 into a. So you will get 9a. Right. Now this multiplication, the minus minus will come, plus 13 threes are 39 plus b. Okay. So we will make this subtraction, because one negative, one positive. So subtraction will be there. 39 minus 27. How much you will get? 39 minus 27. Here you will get 2, and 3 minus 2 is 1. Positive or negative will be there? Of course, positive. So 12 minus 9a plus b equals to 0. So minus 9a plus b plus 12 equals to 0. This is your second. Okay, we have to find the values of a and b. For that purpose, we have to solve this first equation and second equation. Okay, so here, what is the first equation? Now, constant number, from this, we will put like this, minus a plus b equals to this constant. This number will be sent to number side, so 0 plus minus 12 will become plus 12. So you will get minus a plus b equals to 12. And here similarly, minus 9a plus b equals to minus 12. Okay, this is your second. Now, from this here, by this first equation, either we will take to solve this here, or we will just find the value of a or b. Okay, so I will prepare here the value of b equals to this 12. This minus a will shift to this side, so it will come plus a. So what is the value of b here? We got here only b equals to 12 plus a, and this value of b we will put into this given second equation. Okay, so given is we got what is the second equation. So minus 9a plus, what is the b value we got? 12 plus a. Okay, so 12 plus a equals to minus 12. Right. Now minus 9a plus a, minus 9a plus a, you will get minus 8a, minus 8a, okay, equals to, now this plus 12, we will shift to number side, right? So plus 12 will come here, minus 12, and here already minus 12 is there, so minus 12 and this minus 12. So minus minus, we have to add the numbers and give the same sign. Okay, so you will get minus 24. Understood everyone? This step here, we have got your first equation. From that first equation, we have shift this only the number to the number sign. So finally, you will get minus a plus b, and this plus minus will come to here plus b. Okay, and here We have find the value of a or b, or we have to find out the value of a or b with any variable like this. Means b equals to, now minus a we will shift here, plus 8. Okay, so here we got the B value is 12 plus 8. Okay, so now this same value of B we will shift into this given second equation, means whatever we got in the second equation. Okay, so minus 9A plus B value is 12 plus A, we will shift here. So equals to minus 12. Understood? Now here 9A and this plus A. So minus 9A plus A, you will get minus 8A. And here plus 12 will shift to the number side. So already minus 12 is there. And this plus will come here minus. So minus minus, we have to add the number. So you will get minus 24. Got everyone? Now here this negative sign will get cancelled. And here A equals to 24 by 8. Then 8 ones are and 8 threes are. So you will get 3. Okay, so what is the value of A? You got here value of A is 3. Okay, and similarly we will now find the value of B. Actually, what value of B we got a proper number? No. So here we can find here B equals to 12 plus A is given, right? So 12 plus what is the A? 3. So you got here B equals to 12 plus 3, 15. Understood everyone? Now here, so A equals to 3 and B equals to 15. So what we can say, for which value of A and B, these the given factors are the factors of this polynomial? Yes, of course, for which value? A equals to 3 and B equals to 15. For this value, the polynomial x cubed minus x square minus 13x plus b has the x minus 1 and x plus 3 are as a factor. You can verify by putting the values of a and b here and just cross check whether after taking values of x equals to a, you are getting remainder 0 and here x plus 3 will come here minus 3, you are getting remainder 0. Understood? Now we will see. Next example. Next example, without actual division, prove that 2x raised to 4 minus 6x cube plus 3x square plus 3x minus 2 is exactly divisible by x square minus 3x plus 2. Okay, so here it is mentioned that we don't have to do this like this division. Okay, we don't have to carry out like this division. So without actual division, we have to prove that this polynomial having this factor x square minus 3x plus 2. Okay, so by factor theorem we have to solve this, right? It is, we have to prove that this is the factor. Factor means what we need? The remainder 0. And we have to prove that the remainder becomes 0 by after dividing this polynomial by this. Okay, so in this example we don't have to carry out the long division. So what we can do here, we cannot prepare the directly what is the value of x. Previous example we have learned how to directly find the value of x. We are putting that x value in the given polynomial, but here it is not possible. Okay, because what is the factor it is given? The factor is into the quadratic polynomial form. Okay, so from this quadratic polynomial we have to find what are the factors of this polynomial, means what are the two values of x, because how many zeros will be there or how many values of x will be there? 2, because higher exponent is 2. Okay, so here first we will write, let what is your polynomial p of x equals to 2x raised to 4 minus 6x raised to 3 plus 3x square plus 3x minus 2. Okay, and your g of x, it is given into this form, x square minus 3x plus 2. So first we have to find actually what is your g of x. Okay, if g of x is given into this pattern. Okay, so first we will find from this g of x equals to x square minus 3x plus 2. This is the quadratic polynomial form. So by splitting middle term, we will find out the total actual factors. Okay, factors means this polynomial or this is the divisor, we have to find out in the form of factors. Okay. So here splitting middle term means what is the constant number 2 and what is the coefficient here 1. So 2 ones are 2, positive 2 is here. So factors of the 2 are in such way that middle term will come minus 3. So 2 ones are 2. If we make the multiplication of 2 negative number, you will get positive multiplication. And if we add the 2 negative number, you will get negative number. Okay, so minus 3. So here x square minus 2x, or you write minus x, this minus 2x plus 2. See here, minus x minus 2x, you will get minus 3. Then making the group of 2 to each, here what is the common? X in bracket x minus 1, right? Then minus 2 into bracket, what is the common? 2 is there. So 2 will come outside, here x, and minus minus will come plus. So 2 ones are 2. So you got here x minus 1, x minus 2. Okay, so here which are the factors? Actually means g of x, in case of factors you have right, that will be there x minus 1 and x minus 2. Now we have to cross verify for the same. We have to prove that x square minus 3x plus 2 is a factor or is divisible by, means sorry, this polynomial is divisible by this factor. Okay, so this factor we have to take into this form, right? So x square minus 3x plus 2 means what? X minus 1, x minus 2. Understood? This is this form. Now it means that this polynomial or whatever we have taken here is the divisor which has the factors x minus 1 and x minus 2. So instead of this, we cannot write here directly value of x. So we will use this and we will prove that this is the factor of this given polynomial. Understood? Okay, so here we will start. First we will take the factor is x minus 1. So x minus 1 you have taken it with the 0. So you will get x equals to value 1. And here x minus 2 equals to 0 means you have to take x equals to 2, right? So by using these values into this given polynomial, p of x equals to 2x raised to 4 minus 6x cube plus 3x square plus 3x minus 2. Here first we will take p of 1. So here 2 into 1 raised to 4 minus 6 into 1 cube plus 3 into 1 square plus 3 into 1 minus 2. So here 1 raised to 4 is 1, 1 raised to 3 is 1, 1 square is 1. So here you got 2 minus 6 plus 3 plus 3 minus 2. So 3 plus 3, 6. 6 minus 6, 0. Then 2 minus 2, 0. So you got here 0. So here what? X minus 1 is a factor of given polynomial. For that we will now again check now here p of, what is the second factor we got here? In second value of x is 2. So p of 2 equals to 2 into 2 raised to 4 minus 6 into 2 raised to 3 plus 3 into 2 square plus 3 into 2 minus 2. Understood everyone? Okay, so now here 2 into 2 raised to 4. So 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8, 8 2's are 16. So 2 raised to 4 is 16. 16 2's are 32, right? 32 minus here 2 cube is 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8. 8 6 are 48. Okay? Plus 2 square is 4, 4 3's are 12. Plus 3 2's are 6 minus 2. Okay? Now here this 32 plus 12. 32 plus 12, 12 plus means 32 plus 2, 34. 34 plus 10, 44, 44 plus 6, How much 44 plus 6? 50. Okay, so sum of these three numbers you will get. How much? 50. 50 minus 48. 50 minus 48, you will get 2. Okay, 50 minus 48, here I will write. So 50 minus this 48 minus 2. Now check, 50 minus 48, 2, and 2 minus 2, it is 0. So for these two values, you got the remainder P of 2 equals to 0. It means that this x square minus 3x plus 2 is a factor of this polynomial, or you can say to this polynomial is exactly divisible by this x square minus 3x plus 2. Understood everyone? So we will write here 2x raised to 4 minus 6x cube plus 3x square plus 3x minus 2 is exactly divisible by okay, which x square minus 3x plus 2. X square minus 3x plus 2. Understood everyone? Example is, for what must be added to this given polynomial to obtain a polynomial which is exactly divisible by x minus 3. It means that here this polynomial is given, there one number is missing, means it is not added or not subtracted. Okay, so for that number, after adding this number into this given polynomial, whatever you will obtain the polynomial, that will be exactly divisible by x minus 3. Okay, so we don't know what must be added to this given polynomial. Okay, so first we will write here P of x equals to x cube minus 3x square plus 4x minus 30, and your g of x is equals to x minus 3. Okay, so from here we know that how to find the value of x. So you got x equals to 3. Now question is that what must be added. So whatever your polynomial is given, in that again one number is added. You have to add. Okay, so for that, this polynomial which is exactly divisible by x minus 3. Understood? So whatever now steps we will do here, P of x equals to x cube minus 3x square plus 4x minus 30, which is already equal polynomial with u. In that, what must be added? Let me tell, k must be added. Okay, suppose the example is that what must be subtracted from this given polynomial. So whatever the polynomial given we have, that you have to make the bracket, and what must be subtracted, which you have to give here negative sign. So minus k should be subtracted like this. Okay, so now we will simplify. After that, which is exactly divisible by x minus 3, means it is the factor is which exactly divisible, means you will get remainder 0. Okay, so for that value of k, when you will add, then this polynomial is exactly divisible by x minus 3, means you will get the remainder 0. Now we have added, only here we don't know what is actual k, but it is added here, then you will get remainder 0. Okay, so P of 3 you will get 0, right? So now here this x cube means what? P of 3 we will find out here. X cube means what? 3 cube minus 3 into 3 square plus 4 into 3 minus 30, and this plus k, and you will get here P of 3 equals to 0. After adding this k, then this will be the factor. Okay, so 3 cube is 3 3 is 9, 9 3 is 27 minus 3, 3 square is what? 9, 9 3 is 27. Okay, plus 4 3 is 12 minus 13 plus k. Okay, now here this 27 will get cancelled. This 12 minus 13 you will get minus 1 plus k equals to 0. Now you will write like this, minus k plus minus 1 plus k equals to 0. We will write in this form, plus k equals to 0. Now this number and this is variable used here. So we will shift this minus 1 to this right side. Okay. So you will get a equals to 0. This minus 1 will come plus 0 plus 1. 1. So you got your k equals to 1. So k should be added. Okay. K should be added means what? 1 should be added. We added to this given polynomial. Okay, so when you will add this 2 into the given polynomial, then you will get this polynomial. This newer polynomial is exactly divisible by x minus 3. Now you can cross check. This k value is 1. If you put here 1, so here 1, here 1. So this 12 minus 13, you will get minus 1, and this plus 1, minus 1 plus 1 get 0. Means finally k value, if you put here 1, then minus 1 plus 1 will get 0. Understood? So it means that this x minus 3 will be the factor of this given polynomial, where we will add this given polynomial to 1. Understood?